I, Ragnar, claim this land in the name of all that is red. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Space Engineers. This is Ragnar, and you may have noticed that we are standing in a precarious position. You might say, slightly inverted. And, things are a little weird right now. If I can find my way back. Yeah. Check out these boots, man. They are hideous. However, they perform a very interesting function. That being that with no gravity, that is to say that we have turned our gravity generator off, it will allow us to cling to metallic, really any surface that you've built. As far as I can tell, I haven't actually tried them on an asteroid. It's possible that they do something there. But that is to be explored at a later time. We have a lot of stuff to do today, and I have a lot of stuff to update you guys on. So first things first, I guess, let's check this out. See this nice little yellow sensor thingamajig there? Actually, before we do that, let's just go into first person. We'll turn the gravity back on. All right, gravity generator on. Beautiful. Okay, so we have kind of a functioning airlock thing going on here. This is a sensor, for those of you who don't know, and I have it set up already. These are the settings that I ended up going with, if you want to look at them really quick. But yeah, I have them set for a pretty close proximity before they open, just because I'll be walking by here a lot. And I want to be able to get by it without it just constantly opening in the background. But this will keep our industrial module nice and segregated from the rest of the system. And it'll keep it pressurized for when we evacuate the pressure in our hangar bay. So that is in place, and that's interesting. And I'll walk you through putting one of those guys up. I've got another one over there, but we have yet to finish the one on this side, so we'll do that together. I added a little bit of a catwalk here. I just wanted to kind of, you know, well, we needed a way to get down into what I am calling the maintenance level. And I've set some things up here too. We did finish all of the interior walls, and we got little windows here, very nice. And we have lighting. I'm not satisfied with the layout of the gyroscopes, but it will be fixed at some point. And I totally modified the way the oxygen tanks were set up. So what I did was I disconnected them from the main system. Actually, I haven't even hooked up these hydrogen tanks yet. Those will get hooked up very soon. But they're disconnected from the main system now. Each vent in the corners of the hangar bay has its own oxygen tank. I filled them up to very near 50%. Looks like we're at 42.9 right now. But that's because I've been in and out doing work and whatnot. Oh, and I moved our mission statement down here as well. But I'll show you. We have a button now on our button panel that is specific to the hangar vents. So I just set it up. So you can see here in the setup actions, we have the hangar vents, and that's just the on-off option, or rather the depressurize and pressurize option. So all you gotta do is hit this button and it will suck all the air out of this room. And the nice thing about having these sensors is that it's always gonna keep our industrial module separated, and the eventual question mark modules that are going to be on those sides will be segregated as well. But I can confirm that these little vent window things, they do let gas pass through. And it actually kind of eliminates that animation of the gas shooting out. So I kind of like that. It makes it a little bit more, well, you know, I could take it or leave it. I kind of like it both ways, but it's a thing. So let's check this out. Let's try hitting that button. And I should put my helmet on, because we'll die. So the thing The one complaint I have about this system, I guess I would say, is that because these two rooms are open to each other, you actually have to evacuate the entire volume of both our hangar bay and the maintenance level. But you can see we're already at low. It's doing okay. And yeah, I started at 50% with the tanks because I knew that I was going to be degassing this room, and I wasn't exactly sure how much gas was going to be in there or how much the tanks would fill up once we decided to depressurize. So that guy is depressurized now to the bay doors, and we have no gas exchange. That is fantastic. I like it very much. So I did continue work out here as well, which I will show you. Duplicated this armor shaping around each of the engine modules, and I really like it. I think it gives it a nice protected look, but also a little bit of shape, a little bit of style. We'll probably tweak the colors a little bit more, just to, you know, it's an iterative process. We got a little bit of support going on out here as well, but that's just a temporary structure, most likely, because we do have another level to go down here. And I did get a comment mentioning that we should have built some jump drives, and that's kind of part of the plan for what's going to go down on this bottom level. I'm not even sure that we'll have access necessarily to that part, but we'll see how it pans out. I built out these catwalks as well, and really my intention there, I wouldn't have done it without you guys, but I was looking to kind of work out a style, because I really don't like the way that this looks. So as I was shaping these guys out, we ended up kind of having a weird looking mismatch thing, and I always needed to cover up the conveyors that run just above that block. And there's not really a lot of options in the vanilla game for thin pan. Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm a total idiot. I used some just over there on the floor around the entrance to the maintenance level. We could use flat catwalk panels to cover that up. But I'm kind of committed now. Like I looked at this a lot. I tweaked it. I changed it. And I kind of like how that turned out. So I'm thinking we're going to want to duplicate something like this here. The big challenge, though, is this catwalk isn't long enough. So what we're going to need to do is disconnect these two, which is going to be interesting. I heard through the grapevine that merge blocks aren't working so fantastic right now. So maybe we'll put that off for the time being, because the main mission that I want to hit today involves this guy. So I have done a little bit of thinking about that. That's a problem that I hadn't experienced just yet. The outgassing pushing you outside the range of the sensor? Might need to consider change. Well, I mean, honestly, maybe we'll just deal with it for now, because when we build a module on the end of this guy, this isn't going to be outgassing anywhere. It's this. These doors here are just going to exist purely for the sake of segregating that pocket of air from the hangar bay, which is going to be, you know, doing its thing, whether it be depressurized or pressurized again. So the next thing I wanted to do is, let's just set up a sensor really quick together. I can show you kind of the ins and outs. I've been going with yellow here just to make it kind of stand out. And I think I have everything that I need. Oh yeah. Yeah, no problem. All right. So I believe I already named this door, and let's set it up. So let's look down here. Left extent, I believe, is one that's left if you were facing out from, you know, if your perspective was based on where the sensor is, you'd be looking out at me. So the left extent is going to be to the right of the door, so we want that to be minimal. My right extent is 3, bottom is 0, top is 0. Back extent, I've been putting it 7. It seemed to work pretty well. And I tried it quite a bit. And just 1 meter for the front extent. Audible, detect players on, blah, 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 blah. There's nobody else in this world. Doesn't really matter all that much. So that's on. We'll set up the actions. Let's go to doors. And we are port side. Port door out. Wait. Oh, no. Oh, I forgot to name one of them. Okay. So, yes. Port door out, I believe, is what we're looking for. And we're going to want to open. So, this, where it says closed, it's just indicating that it's closed right now. And you can see we have two spots for actions on the sensor. That's because there are only really two states for the sensor to exist in, that is activated or not activated, and that's based on your proximity, or the proximity of whatever you set it up to be sensing. So we have it closed, and it will open once it senses our presence, unless I'm horribly mistaken, and I might get these doors mixed up. So we'll pull that guy back down. And we'll go closed for when we leave the sensor area. And let's just see if I did it right. Oh, that's promising. Let's try it again. It was pressurized. Very good. Nice. Awesome. First try. Well, I mean, fifth try. But first try on camera. That counts. All right. Now let's just run out here and we'll set up the... Oh, there's no sensor on this door. What are you expecting it to do? And we'll get a little light because it's dark. Place that baby there. Weld her up nice. And I'm thinking that this is going to be door number 8 because I don't think I have another door that's labeled port. But yeah. Oh, fun little fact for people who, like myself, have... Is that right? Oh, it's open right now. That's right. For people who always struggled with starboard and port, you know, maybe you can come up with a better mental trick for remembering which is which, but I always remembered it in that port and left both are words with four letters. And that correlates... Why are you not active? Oh, I didn't set up the proximity. So left extent 1, right extent 3, 0, 0, 7, 1. All right. Can you sense me? Are you sensing me? You're not sensing me? Uh-oh. All right. I got my left and right mixed up. Yeah, I only did that like 700 times in the other ones as well. That's okay. Now. Very nice, very nice. And very nice. All right. So we're good there. All right, so the primary mission today. Actually, let's go look at the board. And I'll just show you. We've got some primaries and some secondary missions. And I intend to achieve the primary ones. The secondary ones, as always, will be the optional extras. So we want to load up Apollo. That's it's the only ship that I know can make it to the surface of the moon relatively safely. But we're going to dump it full of components. And I've been thinking about it. I'm guessing it's going to be about... capable of about 1,000,000 kilograms of material, you know, supporting it and flying about the surface of the moon with that. And I'm basing that off of our first trip out into space when we took it off the Earth and went to pick up our platinum. Because if I recall correctly, we had about 250,000 kilograms of platinum that time, plus whatever we had in the tanks for ice. And we were able to land safely in 1G, and being that we have 1/4 G out on the surface of the moon, I'm thinking that should work out okay. We'll see how that does. But yeah, so we're going to load it up with components, we're going to fly down on the surface, we're going to check out our site for the moon base, and I want to set up temporary storage, and definitely offload the ship, and we'll search around and see if we find any other interesting ore deposits, and if we get to it, maybe we'll construct the oxygen system, sealed habitat, and a temporary refinery. It's going to be temporary, obviously, because we want to get set up and we want to get going on the surface. And, you know, anything that we really need to produce in bulk, we can just come back to the space station here. That's the point of having it in orbit. And it's beautiful, too, because we are so close to the surface. So let's just fly up here, we'll back up a little bit, go over to the side. And yeah, I'm going to load this baby up. We're going to hook it up to the connector on the bottom of the industrial module, which is, in my opinion, the least aesthetically pleasing part of the ship. But we'll get to it, guys. We'll get to it. You know, it's just takes time. And I don't want to bore the crap out of you guys with this, you know. Episode 87, still working on the detail work of the industrial module. You know what I mean? So, but yeah, I'm going to load her up, and I will meet you guys back down on the surface. Alright, now we are on final approach. Let's just turn on some of those. I'll get some of the dampers going. We're not that close. You can see our landing platform there, which you guys have not seen except for in our image, or rather our thumbnail for the episode where we went to the moon. We are slowing down, but we're not exactly stopping. And we'll just fire up the secondaries a little bit. Move it forward some more. Let's be a little careful here. And very slow now. Careful. Bringing it in. Very good, very good. All right. Yeah, if you can't tell, I like cycling the dampers. Just because it seems like a slightly more conservative method of approaching and not using up all of our fuel. So, come on. Get it down there. Nice and gentle. How we doing? Ooh, we're close. Alright. And contact. Lock the gear. Turn off the thrusters. And hop out. Alright, so this is the beautiful sight of our new base on the moon. I am excited to get going here. When we came back last time, I was like, oh man, what if I just started building there though? But I wanted to get a little bit further on our other existing projects. So let's step back for a minute. We'll take a little bit of a view here. I don't have a lot of stuff planned. I have some preliminary ideas. But yeah, no solid plans for everything that's going to be going in here. You know what, let's just check out our GPS points that we've already got located here. Right, lunar. This is tedious and I should cut it out, but it is almost done here. If I just talk a little bit slower, it won't seem like it takes so long. There we go. And what have we? All right. Yes, we definitely did some good explorations around here. We've got tons of stuff marked, and as I recall, we found pretty much everything. I think we found actually everything, even platinum, which is cool. And we got a big nickel deposit right there. So, we have some space, for sure. We've got this little mountainy thing. I was thinking about maybe a tower coming up off of that, but you know, just looking at the size of our platform there, it looks relatively small, but if we're going to go for like a serious base here, we might actually want to cut that mountain, like completely destroy that mountain. Or, gosh, what's the word for it? when you have a huge meteor impact, somebody help me out in the comment section. Huge meteor impact and everything gets molten and it actually erupts back outward. I don't remember what that's called. But yeah, this is a cool location for sure. And I am looking forward to what we can do. So I'll tell you what, guys. I'm going to give you a little bit of a cut here, and I'm going to get organized. I'm probably going to throw down a storage container and start transferring everything out of the ship so that we can lighten that baby up and get it ready in case we need to make a jump back into orbit, which you can actually see with the naked eye. I hope the resolution is good enough on YouTube that you can actually see the space station there. But, ooh, and we got a nice view of Mars there and the alien planet and the sun. One thing I do want to be doing here, because I know, and I've been watching from orbit, the way that the sunlight proliferates across the surface as the day progresses, which, by the way, footnote, our day duration as I play it here is actually synchronized with one real world day. So the sun doesn't move fast, but that means that our nights are going to be long. And this place does fall into darkness for a period of time. So that'll be a little bit challenging because I am interested in experimenting with the batteries and the solar arrays and seeing if we can get as much juice out of the sun as possible so that we're not using up our plethora of uranium that we have back on the station. But anyway, guys, I'm going to make a little bit of a cut here. I'm gonna throw down some storage. We'll dump everything out of the ship and we can kind of, you know, I'll look around and I'll think a little bit more and I'll give my ideas when we come back. I, Ragnar, claim this land in the name of all that is red. No, but seriously, I've been working away here. We've got a little bit of a base, as you can see. Definitely made some mistakes, which I will illustrate. As you can see, we have some batteries here. And they've charged up to some degree, not very much. This one's about a third full, I think. Yeah, a little over a third full. And this one is just misplaced so that it doesn't match because, yeah, that's annoying. But yeah, I started to build up things on this platform here and then decided I wanted something else. So I rebuilt, or rather built an entirely different landing platform. And I tore down the solar panels, which I did have over there just to charge those batteries up and give myself a source of oxygen. But I've kind of worked myself into a corner here. As you can see, I'm running low there, and my other two oxygen and hydrogen bottles are almost empty. And I don't have a working source of power here as far as this oxygen generator is concerned. So that isn't running. I can't really replenish my supplies. And a horrible design flaw with Apollo here. I can't move my oxygen and hydrogen bottles into or out of the oxygen generator for the ship. It's actually got small conveyors, so that kind of screws us there. But I can jump in and replenish my in-suit supply. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to drop off. Well, we're going to cut down these batteries. Goodbye, all that power. And yep. And we'll drop this stuff in here. As you can see, I screwed up a little bit earlier. So yeah, those power cells, if you don't know, once you grind them down, they're gone, which is a shame. Right. Still too heavy to lift off with our primary thrusters. So let's fly over. Oh. That's right. I shut my gyros off because I do that when I'm parked for a long time. But yeah, I've got a little bit of a structure dome type thing going over here. I like it. I fiddled a bit with the aesthetics. I think I have a design basically figured out. And we're going to be working on incorporating or making a space for our refineries as well. What is up? What is up? You don't want to link up? Oh, there's no power. Oh, no. Oh, I'm going to have to do this manually. That's a bummer. All right, well, I'll park it over here and just drop her on the landing pad. And I'm not going to make you guys watch me transfer all these items manually. That would be annoying. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to do that. We'll get everything out of the ship, bring her down to race weight, so to speak. And I'm going to take it back up. We'll tear that guy down too, and we'll drop all that stuff in. The only reason that I decided to build in an entirely different location was really, I guess, just being detail-oriented, because I wanted this to kind of be facing the Earth head-on, like, directly, and that was slightly askew. Also, it was really close to that that center part there. So, yeah, let me get going on this. I'm gonna painstakingly transfer everything over into our small cargo containers here, and I will bring you guys back when I'm coming back in, or rather, not when I'm coming back in. I'm gonna bring you guys back because we're running out of time on this episode. I'm gonna bring a whole second load of stuff down here. I'm gonna complete all that stuff. We're gonna get this thing pumping full of oxygen, and I'll see you guys back once we have that done. And done. All right, ladies and gentlemen, check out our habitat. Looks a bit like an igloo, but it seems to function pretty well. We do have it all sealed up, which is fantastic. I will show you just inside. We could take our helmet off. Ah, very nice. We have air. So, got a little bit of lighting. Got plenty of space here. We do still need a med bay so that we can come back and respawn when we do something stupid and die. But, we are fully functional. We have a pressurized place to stay on the moon, and that is wonderful. I'm very happy about that. Oof. Took a little damage there. Yeah, we also need to be able to heal, so that's a thing as well. Made my second run. Dumped all of our stuff in there. As it turns out, we're really going to need to get refining and get assembling down here as well, because this ship, honestly, although I love it, it's not really adequate in terms of volume of stuff that we can carry. We can do the mass. We're not even halfway of its capacity in terms of being able to land on the moon safely, but I really don't want to tear it down and, you know, lengthen it out. Like, I like the look of it. It's got good proportions. I'm not going to mess with it. So, long-term future goal, we're definitely going to shoot to have some sort of lander, something that's made to carry a huge amount of mass up to our space station way up there. We have a battery array. Put it all in. They've been charging up for a little while. They're at a little bit over a third, I think. Yeah, 1.28 out of 3. So those are good. And I set one of these batteries to automatic so that we could have power for the main systems and keep our place oxygenated, rather. And yeah, I think overall it turned out pretty good. Not bad for a single episode. Let me know what you think down in the comments section. But I just gotta thank you guys. You guys have been so supportive. You've left a lot of really nice comments. Like, I was expecting a lot more hate, a lot more negativity, given, you know, YouTube's reputation sometimes. But you guys have been so nice, and I can't thank you enough. And I hope that you enjoyed today's episode. If you did, you know, give me a like. Show your support. I would appreciate it greatly. But that's going to be it for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.